As a scientist, one of the most exciting things is when an experiment or an analysis challenges the way that you've been thinking about something. The Huntington's disease gene was discovered about 30 years ago, and ever since then, the big question has been, how do these changes in the gene lead to the symptoms of the illness?
A lot was known about Huntington's disease before we started this work, but there were sort of gaps and inconsistencies in the knowledge.
Science builds in bits and pieces, so we all build on each other's knowledge.
Huntington's disease is a genetic illness. It runs in families. The symptoms don't appear until midlife in most people. Today, there are no treatments that are known to stop or slow the progression of Huntington's disease. Huntington's disease is caused by a DNA repeat in which a short DNA sequence, CAG, is repeated over and over again a variable number of times. Most of us inherit a form of the gene with 15 to 30 CAG repeats, but people who inherit a form with 40 or more CAG repeats will go on to develop Huntington's. Several years ago, our lab developed a technology for analyzing gene expression in thousands of cells at once. For this project, we further developed that technology so that we could also measure the length of the disease-causing CAG repeat in the individual cells.
Trying to figure out and kind of zoom in on those neurons in particular and figure out what gene expression changes take place in those neurons was particularly important.
The surprising thing that these experiments taught us is that the genetic variation that people inherit isn't actually harmful. It's just that it's unstable. And slowly throughout the course of a person's life, that genetic variant, that DNA repeat, will get longer and longer. And it's only when it becomes extremely long that it even begins to cause harm. So that's a really different way of thinking about how disease arises from genes and genetics.
If we understand the whole trajectory of the pathology, this gives us many different time points at which we can intervene, potentially many different therapeutic targets, maybe with different modalities that can all lead to potential treatments.
As a therapeutic approach, there's something that's really exciting about it. So first of all, it might be able to help with many DNA repeat disorders, not just Huntington's disease. Second, it might be able to prevent some of these disorders and not just treat the symptoms.
This study is perhaps in the first time in my life have the feeling of something that is impactful in the very short term. Without the altruism of brain donors and their families that have been willing to leave a legacy of knowledge that led to this discovery, none of this would have been possible.
This discovery isn't itself a drug, but it's an understanding and a direction that we're hopeful could help lead to new options, and that's a really exciting feeling.